Now we will do little bit of meditation. So everybody can sit erect. Close your eyes gently. Relax your shoulders. Let your head, neck and the spine be in a straight line. If you are sitting on the chair, ensure that your feet are firmly placed on the ground. Come to a comfortable posture without any strain in any part of the body. Have a gentle smile on your face. Thank the Lord for all the blessings that we have in life. Invoke gratitude in the heart and genuinely thank the Lord for having blessed us with good health, with prosperity, with people to love us, with all the accomplishments in life, as well as all the challenges which help us to grow. And most importantly, this human birth to strive and realize our oneness with Shiva. Thank the Lord for everything that we have in life, for the spiritual knowledge, for all the sadhanas we have been able to do on all the Mondays. This is a first step, preparation and posture. Second step is auto-suggestion. Suggest to the mind that for the next 15 minutes, I am steady and still without any movements. A still body is very important for a still mind. So suggest to the mind that for the next 15 minutes, I am steady and still without any movements. I am alert, awake, and quiet. This is the second auto-suggestion. I am alert, awake, and quiet. Generally, our mind is asleep when we are quiet. Third auto suggestion. For the next 15 minutes, I am only a devotee of the Lord. The only role I have is I am a devotee of the Lord. Everything else can wait. I am only a devotee at this moment. Third step, present moment awareness. Be aware of the simple happenings around you. The feel of the chair, the feel of the ground, maybe the chillness in the atmosphere if you are in an AC. Any other sounds around you? Just be aware of the simple happenings moment by moment. We generally live in our memories. We don't live in the moment. So bring the mind away from the past and future. Be in the moment. Without any judgments, just be aware of anything happening around you. Fourth step and fifth step are relaxation of the body and deep breathing, which we will combine. Be aware of the whole body from the head to the toes. And as I say, inhale, take a slow, steady, and deep breath without any jerks. And as I say, relax, exhale slowly, letting go of all stress and strain. Exhale all the air. Inhale. Relax. Inhale. Continue to breathe slow, steady, and deep. Deep breathing relaxes the body and quietens the mind. The sixth step is invocation. Invoke the auspicious form of Lord Shiva. In the space between the two eyebrows or in your heart, visualize a circle of white light. And invoke the auspicious form of Lord Shiva. He is sitting amidst the beautiful mountains of Kailash. Bhagwan has a long jata, symbolic of austerity. Gangaji flows from his jata, symbol of devotion and service. There is a crescent moon on the jata of the Lord, representing a steady mind, a contemplative mind. The Lord has a third eye on his forehead. The other two eyes are closed in Shambhavi Mudra. They are half open and half closed. Compassion, justice, and intuitive wisdom. These three are the eyes of the Lord. There is a gentle smile of inner bliss on his face. Bhagwan has Rudraksha on his jata, in his ears as the kundal, and on his neck. On his arms, on the wrist, Bhagwan wears a Rudraksha mala. There is a snake around his neck, the symbol of time. Bhagwan is eternal. The neck of the Lord is blue in color, symbol of compassion. Bhagwan applies the ash of detachment all over his body. He wears an elephant skin, symbolizing mastery over lust. And he sits on a tiger skin, mastery over aggression and lower animalistic nature. Bhagwan is sitting in Padmasana, absorbed in meditation. There is a Trishul with a Damaru beside him. There is a Nandi in front of the Lord, ever alert, ever watching the Lord. This is the auspicious form of Lord Shiva, Jagadishwara. the Lord of the universe. Imagine that you are in front of the Lord, seated at the feet of the Lord. And we invoke this auspicious form, Shivam Shantam Jagannatham Loka Nigrahakarakam Shivame Kapadam Nityam Shikaraya Namo Namah. Lord Shiva is auspiciousness, is complete peace, is the Lord of the universe, always strives to do good for the humanity, for all the worlds. Shiva alone is the true state of consciousness, which is eternal. Our prostrations to that Lord Shiva. Keeping this form in the mind, or if you like a Shivalinga, visualize a Shivalinga. We will chant Om Namah Shivaya. 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 ओम नमः शिवाय, 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 ओम कंटिन्यू मेंटली। Shiva is the truth. Shiva is auspiciousness. And Shiva is bliss. Satyam, Shivam and Sundaram. Shiva is the pure consciousness in us. Sat, Chit, Anand. May the grace of Lord Shiva be with all of us. May our minds always revel in Bhagwan Shiva. Tanme Mana Shiva Sankalpamastu. May our lives be pure, positive, peaceful. Mentally offer some flowers at the feet of Lord Shiva. Perform a pradakshina of Lord Shiva. And come to prostrate in surrender to the Supreme Lord. Feel that the hand of Bhagwan is on your head. The grace and blessings of Lord Shiva are always with us. We have to become more receptive towards his grace. Be aware of your breath. Pay attention to inhalation and exhalation. Be aware of the body. Be aware of the happenings around you. We pray for the well-being of everyone. May everyone be happy. May no one go through any sickness or pain. May all of us come out of this crisis as soon as possible. Feel that you are as though a transmitter, and from your heart you are sending out waves of love, happiness, peace to the whole world. Om Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinah, Sarve Santu Niramayah, Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu, Ma Kaschid Dukha Bhak Bhavet. Om Asatoma Sadgamaya, Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya, Mrityurma Amritam Gamaya. Om Purnamadat Purnamidam Purnat Purnamadachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om. Rub your palms, place them on the face, and gently open the eyes.